So, hi everyone. Welcome to another edition of the Corporate Slave Learn from the Best series. So, today I'm very thrilled to talk to my guest. So, her name is Ditta Siena-De Guzman. So, she's currently working as a supervising human resource specialist in the Office of the Human Resource Management and Development, which is under the CSC or the Civil Service Commission. So yeah, one thing to note also that she holds a master's in public policy, which she got from Meiji University Graduate School of Governance Studies in Tokyo, Japan. So yeah, big time, no? So yeah, as you can see, on the screen, she's very accomplished and an outstanding public servant. So in my channel, of course, I want to showcase the different careers, and I believe that Ditta is an epitome and an advocate of what good governance is. And kumbaga, if meron people like her that serves the country with integrity and pride as she strives for greatness and is passionate about improving herself by means of education. So, yun, looking at her achievements, you can really be in awe. So, despite her busy schedule, she devotes her time to her husband, Matt Daryl, and their baby girl, Iwaga. So, it is truly an honor for me to talk to her today and tell her story. So, yun, let's go. Now, mga viewers, I would like for you to welcome our very special and esteemed guest today. So, Miss Ditta Siena. So, like what I've said in our introduction with her earlier, so she's a supervising human resource specialist. So, yeah, from the Office of the Human Resource Management and Development. So, under the Civil Service Commission. So, yun, grabe, ang haba, pero yun, with a lot of accolades under your belt, siguro, yun, yeah, I've seen din na you've gone from corporate and gone to civil service. So, sige, can you let's start, and can you share with us your career experience and how long have you been in the industry, and you know, what's the achievement that you are most proud of?
So una po sa lahat, magandang araw po sa inyong lahat, sa mga nanonood, at sobrang honored po ako to be part of this initiative ni Kuya Chris, no, kasi it's really good to inspire people, especially nowadays, no? Siguro, paano ko ba simulan? I graduated from UP in 2010. Siguro 1 month pa lang po akong gumagraduate. Nagtatrabaho na ako. I started in the private sector sa Frontera Brands. Yung mga products niya, yung Anlene, Angkor,
okay,
kumbaga household products na rin, mga gatas, keso, yan, mga cream. So, I started with them, and after that, nirecommend ako nung boss ko doon to to her friend sa Ayala Land International Sales Inc. So, sa marketing din, pero ang difference from Frontera Brands, I was assisting my boss doon sa market research.
Okay.
Pero sa Ayala Land International Sales, ang work ko talaga doon is more on, as in, marketing.
Okay.
Hindi ko kami nabenta doon. Iba yung sales sa marketing.
Okay.
So, kami yung support. Kasi, since international siya, ang, syempre, market, mga Filipinos abroad.
Okay.
So, yung marketing team, kami yung nagka-conduct ng business development for the sales people bago sila pumunta dun sa country, sa iba't ibang countries. we go there first.
Okay.
We interview people, we do research, yun, business development. So, kami yung nag-establish muna ng network doon bago sila pumunta.
Okay.
So, we're like a support the sales team. Sila talaga yung, kumbaga, sa ano, kumbaga, frontliner sila. Kami yung support team.
Okay.
So, we do events. I used to do events abroad. Ang assignment ko, ASEAN countries.
Okay.
And then, sabi nga nila, bakit ko umalis? Ang ganda-ganda ng Ayala. So, parang, it's a dream job for people who were starting.
Yes.
Kasi, I was able to travel abroad sa ibang countries. So, bakit ako umalis? Sabi ko nga, parang focus up, medyo crazy yung move ko. May reason was, sabi ko talaga, gusto kong mag-aral.
Okay.
Gusto ko talagang mag-masters. I was already thinking of pursuing a master's degree sa UP Diliman.
Okay.
Even before I graduated from college.
Okay.
So, sabi ko sa sarili ko, I will pray for this. I will ask God when is the right time. And I found the right time. So, the right time was after a year in Ayala Land. Sabi ko, I need to grow. I need to feel that I'm growing. Yung sarili ko talagang effort. So, I went to UP Diliman. And then, doon naman, I met the dean of the Department of Communication ng Colegio de San Lorenzo.
Okay.
Who got me naman, who handled their the college's marketing office.
Okay.
So, naging marketing officer ng Colegio de San Lorenzo. And subsequently, dream come true rin, nakakatuwa kasi college pa lang, gusto ko na talagang i-share yung sabi ko, gusto ko magturo.
Okay.
Hindi ko naman inaasahan na while performing as ano, while working as marketing officer ng Colegio de San Lorenzo, na-top na rin ako as ano, part-time lecturer.
Wow.
So, yun na, tuloy-tuloy na siya. And then, through that work, may guesting yung school sa isa, sa, I think it was PT before,
okay,
government. Yun. So, during that TV guesting, nandun yung ano, parang may na-meet ako na taga civil service. Sabi niya,
okay,
uy, mag-apply ka sa amin. Kami ganun. So, sabi ko, sige po, try lang, ganyan. Pero kasi I was very happy with my work na dun sa school.
Sa school, okay.
Sabi ko, satisfied na ako. Kumbaga, kung makuha ko, di, sa government, di, okay. Thank you, Lord. Pero kung hindi, okay na rin kasi happy na ako dun sa work ko. Pero nakuha ako, so parang, because, sige, leap of faith.
Okay.
So, I started in government after more than 2 years in the private sector.
Okay.
I joined the government in 2013. January 2013 to be exact. Tapos, hanggang ngayon po, tuloy-tuloy na. So, I was able to grow my career. I was able to find my spot in the society through the government. Kaya parang, na-inlove talaga ako sa public service.
Wow.
Kasi nakaka-adid maglingkod kahit na minsan nakakalungkot. Nakakapagod, nakakapagod.
Yeah.
Pero pag pala nakita mo yung sarili mo sa right industry or sa right sector na para sa'yo, ma-feel mo na talagang nandun ka, yun yung spot mo.
Yeah.
So I was able to feel early on pa lang. So, hindi ko, not a day passed by na parang ayoko na. So, parang everyday
exciting.
Ano, go lang. Go. Excited pa rin akong pumapasok even until now.
Wow, that's good. Sabagay.
Ano yung tanong ko?
Hindi, yun, tama. You're correct. Kasi, yun nga, sabi nga nila, di ba? Kasi, man, if you're happy with what you're doing, you never have to work a day in your life. Eh. So, I think you're an epitome of that. And then, yun nga, sa mga viewers, siyempre, it's good na you always dream, you always try to improve, you always look for the next or the better version of yourself. Eh. So, yun, kumbaga, you're an example of that. And being a good governance advocate talagang, I think, people, especially, yun nga, yung mga kabataan, would see the value in public service. Kasi right now, syempre marami tayong bad rep, pero yun, with people like you na give good light to government service. So, kumbaga, it's good na you can share your story with them para makita naman nila and ma-inspire sila. So, sige, for my next question, what is your go-to mantra to be successful?
Go-to mantra to be successful? Honestly, at this point, even yun nga yung mga nasabi kanina na, sabi mga Kuya Chris, yung accolades. Even until now, even with those, sabi natin, accomplishments, mas di ko pa rin masabi na entirely successful ako. Because I see my work in the government as really public service. Whatever I do na para sa sarili ko, I try to give back. So I try to apply it dun sa work ko. So siguro kung go-to mantra for success, meron kasi akong dun sa una kong work, yung very first boss ko shared to me, because of course I was very young then, that was more than 10 years ago.
Okay.
Sabi niya sa akin, if bibigyan ka ng maraming trabaho, accept it wholeheartedly, because that means the organization, your boss, they trust you.
Okay.
So hanggang ngayon, dinala ko yun. Kasi yung iba, some people, pag maraming binibigay na assignments, maraming trabahong binibigay, parang, bayan, dami-dami. O di kaya, bayan, ako na lang lahat. Ganun. So, sa akin, hindi. Parang, the more na binibigyan ako ng work or ng mga tasks or mga assignments, I really welcome that. So, I think it's the go-to mantra for success. For me, ha?
Okay.
That when you are given special assignments, when you are given tasks, welcome it as if it's another challenge for you to improve yourself, and to it's an opportunity for you to contribute. So, yun. Kasi if people will think na sige, bigyan niyo lang sa akin, I will do my best. Then, di ba, parang mawawala na sa vocabulary natin yung mediocre thinking. So, yun, parang lahat tayo, okay, lahat tayo, maganda yung performance. So, walang may iwan sa laylay.
Okay, I agree with you. And thank you for sharing that. I think one of the traits of being successful is yun nga, attitude towards work. And I think yun, nadala mo yun ever since yung first time mo nag-work until now. Kasi if you strive to be successful, syempre, yung attitude mo towards work na, kumbaga, you try to accept everything and do everything in your power to do the best that you can. So I think that's attitude eh. And yun, so I think that's a good trait that you have, and I think that's one of the traits that makes you successful. You know, one of the things din na successful people have as a trait is being humble. So I think that's one of your traits as well. So yun, thank you for that. So yeah, now for my next question, yun, I think medyo na-answer mo na to, pero I think what is your greatest inspiration in your career?
Yeah, I was thinking, habang sinasabi mo yun, Kuya Chris, parang naiisip ko, I'm trying to go back dun sa mga naging mentors ko. Actually, I must say that parang yung success, kung sabihin natin, kung i-define natin yung success, yung success hindi lang siya sa'yo. Parang hindi ka naging successful ng ikaw lang.
Yeah.
People help you along the way. So, or people, your mentors, your boss, your superiors, gave you the opportunity to do great things. That's why you are successful now. So, masasabi ko na one of those people talaga is yung naging una kong boss sa Civil Service Commission.
Okay.
And I'm proud to share her name. She's a government official. A Director Maria Luisa Salonga. She was my first boss in the government. She's still the director of the Public Assistance and Information Office ng CSC. So that's where I started. And she was actually the one who told me na, huy, try mo mag-apply sa CSC. And I didn't know that she will be my boss.
Okay.
So parang nakakatuwa lang kasi hindi ko siya kilala.
Okay.
I honestly didn't know anybody in the government. Di ba yung sinasabi na kailangan mo ng backer, gano'n.
Okay.
I didn't have anyone. So I just tried, I just tried applying.
Okay.
And sa kanya ko nakita na yung pagiging objective mag-isip na at all times in the workplace, maintain professionalism.
Yes.
So if you are professional, people will, I mean, you don't need to ask people to respect you. They will give it to you. You will earn it. So, siya talaga, malimit siyang mag-share ng personal matters.
Okay.
And she's not really the person na yung magkukwento. I mean, we enjoy that, no? Pilipino tayo. Magkukwento tayo. Siya, casually, kwento lang saglit, ganyan. Pero, she's very professional na she knows when to inject personal matters or personal thought. So, parang doon ko sa kanya na, na-adapt ko yun sa kanya na parang, even if, ano, feeling mo parang, banuan tong person na to, napaka naiinis ka sa kanya,
okay,
sa workmate mo, hindi naman kinukuwasan yun.
Pero
sa kanya ko na ano yun, na-adapt na parang you always look at the other side.
Okay.
Parang bakit ba siya naging ganyan?
Okay.
Ano ba yung perspective niya? Try to see the other person's perspective. So
okay,
kasi may tayong ganun eh sa government. Conflicts are very evident.
Yes. No?
Marami tayong conflicting views.
Yeah.
So it's very important that you are professional enough and objective enough to handle things and set aside your emotions.
Yeah.
So yun yung nakuha ko sa kanya. And until now, as a supervisor, iba-iba yung personality ng mga tao natin.
Yes.
So, an essential trait pala as of a leader. So, nakakatuwa na I was very lucky because if I am who define success, siya yung nakasama ko along the way. Kasi more than six boss. So, natutunan sa kanya.
Wow.
Ayun. And another thing, siguro, two things yung naisip ko dun eh. Yung opportunities, if you're given opportunities, grab it. Parang, of course, you'll have time to think about it,
yeah,
but grab the opportunities as if hindi na babalik yun.
Yes.
So habang, yun nga yung turo niya sa amin nun, habang bata pa kayo, if you're given the opportunity to study abroad, grab it or yeah, apply. Try lang ng try. If you're given the opportunity to attend this kind of training, bayad yan. Huwag kang umabsent. Be there early. Finish it. Complete it. Be there until the end. No? So, parang you fully commit yourself to opportunities given to you. So, ayun. Yung sabi niya, o diba? Ngayon, ano ka na? May asawa ka na? May anak ka na? So, you feel na parang hindi ka na naiwan. Kasi
yeah,
bata ka pa, simulan mo ng maaga, tapos grinab mo na yung binigay sa yung opportunities, hindi ka nag-ahabol.
Yes.
Parang ganyan yung ano niya.
Wow,
so,
that's good.
Yun, sorry.
No, that's very good. Kumbaga, I'm really inspired with the story and I think yung mga viewers will learn a lot kasi yun nga, once you're given the opportunity, yeah, you need to grab it and yun nga, tama ka na minsan it doesn't come twice. Eh. So you need to really make the most out of it and kumbaga, try every opportunity that you can. Kasi you'll never know. Eh. Sometimes it's blind luck, sometimes it's skill, sometimes it's talent. Yeah. Pero yun niya, it's really depending on you na yung attitude mo towards that. Eh. And I really also admire yung thing that you shared about empathy. So I think that's what you're trying to say is being there for, and looking at the point of view of the other people. And yun nga, pagka maraming tao in government na katulad mo, kumbaga magiging maganda ang service ng government kasi we all have our own points of view. So it's very good na we understand and we try to put ourselves in their shoes as well. So yun, thank you for that. So siguro for
my alam mo pala Prisa, no?
Sige.
especially nowadays given the pandemic,
yeah,
parang more than anything else, more than public service, sabihin natin ganun, yung sa tao na lang,
yeah.
If you are in the government, it's really important for people in the government to empathize,
yes.
To have that high sense of empathy.
Yeah.
Kasi, if you don't try to understand people na, kunyari, sa local government unit ka, hindi mo sila intindihan yung mga nasasakupan mo, sabi natin ganun.
Yeah.
Diba? Parang, how will you able to provide for their needs? Or,
yes.
Or how will you able to talk to them in a very, parang, kalmado way?
Yes.
So, parang napaka-importante sa ngayon, lalo na ngayon,
yes.
Na people are getting sick, di ba? Health is the number one priority ngayon. So we should try to understand people, we should try to understand each other. And that's the parang basic support na kaya nating ibigay.
Yeah.
As people in the government. Dun sa mga taong pinaglilingkuran natin.
Yeah.
It's to, paano kay, for example, isipin mo ba may COVID sa paligid tapos papupuntahin mo yung mga tao doon sa opisina, papipilahin mo?
No.
Di ba parang kung ito kaya po sila?
Oh,
di ba? So, those simple things in the government, sobrang malaking tulong sa mga tao if lalagay mo yung sarili mo sa katayuan nila, you'll be able to effect changes based on ano yung magiging impact dun sa mga tao ng mga changes na yun. So, something
yeah.
Like that.
So, I hope yung mga bosses mo and, well, yung people in public office can see this video para at least yun nga, they can understand yung hardships ng mga tao. So, yeah, I really appreciate you saying that coming from being, ayun nga, an advocate of good governance. So, thank you. So at least it gives us hope na mga, well, people like me na normal citizens na there are people like you in the government that tries to look after the welfare of the people. So, yon. So, Ditta for President. Pero anyway, siguro, for my next question, well, with all the accomplishments, with all the things under your belt, ano pa ba ang nakakapag-inspire sa isang Ditta daily? Like, what do you look forward to? Can you share some light on that?
Well, aside from my daughter, syempre my husband.
Kasi Mats.
He inspires me. Kasi waking up with the two of them beside me, it's really an energy booster.
Okay.
So, yun, talagang when you start the day together with your family, you know that nothing can go wrong. Parang
gano'n.
Yeah. But aside from them, from family, siguro what inspires me is yung hope na if you're given 8 hours to work, and to share what you know, to share your capabilities. Imagine just one person na mapangiti mo or matulungan mo sa isang araw, and you have in your lifetime, how many days in your lifetime, diba? So that's how many people you were able to help in your lifetime.
Yeah.
So parang it inspires me na kahit isang tao lang na mabigyan ko ng right information tungkol sa government services in a day, yun, talagang ano na ako dun, looking forward ako sa ganun po. Kasi, siguro parang ang kalaban kasi ngayon ng government and, well, in general, people in general, is misinformation.
Yes.
So, parang I try to inspire myself by thinking na if I'm able to provide the right information to people who are asking me about government services, then I'll be able to really help them. So, just by helping people through information, napaka-powerful na. So, sabi ko, pag may nagme-message po sa akin, you can just imagine my inbox.
Oo, marami.
Yung iba, hindi ko na nababasa yung iba. So, but I always try to read everything.
Okay.
Before I sleep, habang nag-breastfeed kayo, hiwaga. So, I try to read everything in my inbox, sa messenger, sa email. So, kapag may humihingi ng tulong, even if people who hindi ko na po kilala,
okay,
may ganun, refer lang na ni-refer na, ni friend, ganito, ni friend. Even if I really do not know them, the mere fact that they're asking me, it just means that they trust me to provide them the right information. So, it's really, it's something that inspires me to do, to be a good person every day.
Yeah. Thank you. Well, very well said. Very well said, Ditta. So, siguro, in relation to that, ano bang isang pro tip or diskarte na you can give for those people na who want to join in your line of work?
I got this tip. So, actually, yung mga sinishare ko dito, parang ano lang din eh. Natutunan ko lang along the way from other people who really inspired me to be a better public servant. Pero itong isishare ko na tip, I got it from my father kasi he used to be a civil servant and he used to be a public servant. Nag-serve siya through the Department of Agriculture years back, decades na.
Okay.
So, sabi niya sa akin, if you really want to join the government, actually, sinabi niya sa akin yun when I was still in college, kasi, syempre, UP, ang turo sa University of the Philippines is that para sa bayan,
yes,
yung maglingkod sa bayan.
Yes.
So, yun yung isa sa mga prinsipyong tinuturo. And I can say that I was able to imbibe that principle. So sabi ko, in my own ways, I will try to give back kasi kumbaga pinag-aral kami ng sabayan ng Pilipino. So sabi ko, gusto ko rin mag-government kasi tinanong niya ako, ano ba gusto mong maging career mo?
Yeah.
So, gusto ko mag-government pero hindi ko alam kung paano, hindi ko alam kung saan. Ayoko dun sa mga mapolitika. Ayoko dun sa mga magugulo.
Yeah.
So, gusto ko ng tahimik na buhay na makakapaglingkod ako.
Yeah.
So, I never thought na the CSC will be that organization. So, sobrang swerte ko talaga na dito ako napunta. I think it's meant to be. Pero, yun nga, if you will try to look at the yung naging career path ko, I started in the private sector.
Yes.
So sabi ko, kung tip lang, if we want to, if young people would want to practice or would want to imbibe the yung empathy, yung sense of empathy,
yeah,
you start with you start from the outside the government.
Yeah.
So you will work outside the government, you will see things from other perspective.
Yeah.
Kasi ang tendency, when you enter the government, you'll become saturated in the government.
Okay.
So parang isipin mo na lang, ito yung nakagawian sa gobyerno, ito lang susundin natin.
Okay.
But if you came from outside, or sabihin natin, okay, you started in the government, you try to do things outside the government. You engage in social civic works, you join organizations na nakakatulong sa iba,
okay,
or you join an whatever organization, at least you'll be able to see other things aside from the perspective of the government. It's very important kasi if masaturate ka na sa government, yun yung sinasabing makakain ng sistema. So, it's a good tip, and I think not many people will share that tip to you, to young people who want to join the government. Kasi, ang pagtingin, nako, government is a very prestigious work, no?
Yes.
Prestigious, ano, kasi, pag walang government, wala na, anarchy na ito.
Yes,
so, kumbaga, hanggat may gobyerno, secured ka. Parang ganun yung pagtingin natin,
yes,
diba? So, kaya nga, before you enter the government, you do things, or and you should practice seeing things from other perspectives, from outside the government. Then you join the government and be part nung makikita mo, ah, gusto kong baguhin yung ganito, gusto kong magkaroon ng pagbabago, and then be part of that change.
Yeah.
Do the change, parang gano'n.
Yes. Ako, very well said. So, siguro ako, I've taken a lot of your time. Siguro last question na lang for me is, well, with all the work that you have done, so meron ka bang for you an exciting material possession or collection na you have right now? And
okay. Hindi siya sobrang material possession, pero it's something that na purchase ko for periods of time. ever since, sobrang na-enjoy kong bumiyahe.
Okay.
Itong magbiyahe. So, when I reached, I think that was in 2015, when I went to Japan for
yes,
a scholarship, doon ko na-appreciate yung mundo.
Yeah.
So, parang may nagsabi sa akin, you're a single person, you're young, explore the world.
Yeah.
So, ako naman, kung ano, nakalimutan ko yun, na gusto ko pala yun, sobrang busy ko sa public service,
yes,
sa pagtuturo, sa pag-exercise. Sobrang busy ka yun. Nakalimutan ko pala yung dream ko na bumiyahe.
Yes.
So, ayun, nag-YOLO ako.
Wow.
So, I made 2015 hanggang 2019. Kung di nagkaroon ng pandemic, hanggang ngayon, nag-YOLO tayo. So, I'm really proud na I was able to travel using my ipon.
Yeah,
and siguro, my biggest pride then is I was able to have my own home.
Wow.
So I was able to buy my own house. So it's
wow,
actually a condo unit. So using my own money, sobrang kuripot ko po nung mas bata ako. kasi sabi ko, pag nagkuripot ako ngayon, later on, I will be able to enjoy it. So,
yeah,
ayun na nga, na-enjoy ko na siya. Mayroon akong matitirhan. And, yun, until I had my family, doon na kami nakatira. So, yun, sobrang, it's my pride of a lifetime. I was able to buy something that big at a very young age. I was able to buy that I was 25 years old. So, ilang years na rin ako nagbabayad ngayon ng amortization. pero, yun, huwag po kayo mag-alala, naka-reflect po yun sa sell-in po.
Yeah, well, wala namang problema doon. I think it's one of the good things na, yun nga, if you earn your money, is also try to spend it on yourself, on the things that you want, kasi it's a way for you to validate your success, and kumbaga, it feels good na you're able, kumbaga, yun yung isa sa mga inspirations mo to go to work is, kumbaga, may bahay ako, I can do travel, so I think, when it's about attitude, it's about, yun nga, yung perspective mo in life, so, yun. Well, Dita, ako, I've really enjoyed our talks, and I know it's been a busy day for you, so I really appreciate yung time that you spent, and yung energy and yung knowledge that you have imparted sa mga viewers natin. So, well, with that said, siguro I'll say thank you again, and of course, stay healthy and stay safe, and
thank you, Kuya Chris.
Thank you. Okay. Bye-bye, Dita. Thank you. Yeah, so there. Thank you for watching another episode of The Corporate Slave. Learn from the best edition. If you like the content, please do hit like and subscribe to support my channel. And if you have comments or suggestions, I do welcome comments below. Or if you want me to share your story, please do reach out to me, and as always, stay safe, and thank you, and see you on the next video.